Thank you so much for being here, and I'm gonna try to speak slowly and curb my enthusiasm. No, I'll keep my enthusiasm. I have been meditating in a focused way for many years. Due to health concerns, I turned to meditation. It helped me, it worked. And about 5 or 6 years ago, during these intense meditations, I started receiving messages, very strong messages, about teaching and my particular approach to meditation, which is sort of to open it up to everyone and make it sort of more somatic and feeling, and just talking about the ways that meditation has completely expanded my world. And I also got a very strong message to write it in a book. And so I did. I wrote it all down. It took about 6-8 months. And I was so excited because I finished it in 2009, and I just heard about Abraham teachings 6 months ago. And I started listening to Abraham, and it was just so exhilarating because what I had described was the same as the vortex, and I just used different words, and I was in that feeling sensation and expansion. And so I just felt so confirmed that there were universal laws, and I was getting that message. And then law of attraction, which I didn't know it was called then, seemed to step in because everything went pretty smoothly, and I got picked up by a publisher, and people said, oh, you can't get published, it's too difficult. And it just, I met the right person at the right time, and it connected.
Because you can be or do or have anything that you want.
Thank you. It was such an exhilarating feeling, and part of the strong message that came when I meditated was as soon as I closed my eyes, boom, I was in front of 300 people explaining my particular approach to meditation and helping people find their approach. Not constricting their approach, but saying, here's a metaphor, and then take it whatever direction you want and see how it works for you. And there I was in front of these 300 people. So when the book got, you know, it's just about to be published, but so I put, you know, I had done that work, and I thought, okay, now I should turn to teaching because I felt like that was the message. So I put up posters and did my first workshop and didn't expect a lot of people, but ended up having a big turnout, and people loved it and have been asking me since to do more. And what happened after that workshop is I got really sick, and all my chronic fatigue stuff came back, and I haven't taught in a year, and people are saying, when are you going to teach? And so I'm trying to figure out where the resistance is, or what the gap is between getting this message and feeling a clear view of doing that, and this feeling of dread of starting a workshop and not getting tired again.
Well, first we want to say that everything's unfolding nicely. In other words, and the reason we say that is because often someone will feel the inspiration to write a book and even follow through and accomplish it. And then they get stuck on the publishing part or the presentation part or the how will the world receive it part. And we always say, it's sort of like our first question today that seemed to set us up for everything we've talked about since, that when you recognize that in the creation of the book, there was a coming, our friend said, I've got it figured out relative to this. How do I figure it out relative to other things? And the same alignment that was necessary in order for the book to flow so easily, and it did, is the same alignment that is necessary for anything else that you want. And there is this misunderstanding, and we heard a little bit of it from you just now, that goes something like, I'm supposed to do it, mm-hmm. that it's meant to be, that now I've stepped into this pattern, I must fulfill it. And the reason that everyone feels resistance about that is because it's not the way it is. It is your personal desire that drives everything, that guides everything, because it's a calling forth. That's why we are so happy to say to all of you, you are the leading edge summoning everything that is forward into the leading edge. Source energy is not asserting you out here and dictating to you what you accomplish. Right. You are discovering your desires and you're summoning it all forward. Can you feel the difference? It's law of attraction. It's not law of assertion. It's summoning forth, you see. So what happens, and it's a very common thing, to have something that you believe in and from your personal experience to it, know the value of it, you can just feel it. Esther said about her mother, we were not encouraging Esther to explain us to her parents because we knew it would not be a happy conversation, ever, as long as they were physically focused. In other words, it was just not something that they, there was so much momentum otherwise, and it wasn't necessary or important. And yet, Esther felt this desire for them to know what she knows. And the thing that sort of was hanging up in her is that when something feels this good, it must be good for everyone. Right. And everyone is not vibrationally ready, no matter how good your book is. But so can you feel the tension in that? Now, we're exaggerating that tension, but there is that sort of angst in it that I should do it. And it is our promise to you that if you'll just step back into the, this is what I want to do, this is what I think I want to do, discover what you want to do, then all of the cooperative components will just fall into alignment.
I have felt that I wanted to do it. I do want to do it. I want to change the career I'm in, and I want to be teaching.
Remember the conversation we had just now, and isn't it lovely how everything just keeps unfolding, unfolding, unfolding out here on the leading edge, where you say that you think you want to do it. You think you want to do it.
I'm pretty sure I want to do it.
I'm pretty sure that I want to do it. I'm pretty sure that I want to do it. And so just sort of flow with that. I'm pretty sure that I want to do it. In other words, the conversations as they've been evolving here today are sort of leading to this awareness that what we said to our friend just now is find a way of believing in something that is unseen.
Right.
And our encouragement to him was to believe in the parts that were easy to believe in. In other words, he was talking about maybe mentoring someone who had never had success, and that's certainly not your case. But let's say that you're the mentor of yourself, as he is the mentor of whatever. Mm-hmm. And so our encouragement to him was to believe in the law, believe in the basis. And so that's why we took you back to, as you were presenting to us how it unfolded for you, your experience there. There was no hesitation. There was no jerkiness. There was no resistance whatsoever until you get into that part where you began to feel it. Yeah. So when you get into that part where you begin to feel it, go back to the part where you don't feel it.
Okay.
In simpler terms and in more law-based terms, what we've been saying recently is there is always more resistant in the specific than there is in the general.
Right.
So the rule of thumb is, when you get into a mode of appreciation, that's really, really specific. If you can get into a mode of appreciation and get more and more and more and more and more specific, you can parlay that into such fantastic alignment that you'll feel passion flowing in the moment. You see it all the time in these gatherings. When we get onto a sort of rampage and run, you can just feel the momentum of it. Everyone is part of it and everyone can feel it.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't want to push that. And so if you're not there, go to a very general place. And you began by telling that story precisely in that way.
Right.
And so go there and find that general place. And go there and find that general place. Because we promise you, you've put enough into your vortex. In other words, all these things that you want is already played out vibrationally speaking.
Right.
You just have to find a way not to be in the way of that. And almost every teacher, and we're still talking to our friend that we spoke to just before, and a lot of you, because this is a room full of teachers and uplifters, almost without exception, when you move through knowing what you know, and we know you're knowing it, we feel you know it, we sit here together and you know it, you know what we know, you are what we are. In other words, it is your information, it is your knowledge that you want to impart to others. So what is the hang up when you begin to impart it to others? What
right.
kinds of things come up? Will they believe me?
Right.
Well, that's doubt in yourself. Are they smart enough to get it? Well, that's doubt in them. Is it marketable? Well, that's doubt in the economy. In other
right.
words, there's just all kinds of things that you've practiced that just hang you up and prevent you from purely just blasting out there
yeah.
like you started, you see.
Yeah.
So what happens is you keep finding these pieces and you feel the breakthrough. And it's lovely to watch you because when it starts breaking through, you want to tell everybody until you've told some of them. And when you tell some of them and it doesn't go over that well, then your observation of that introduces resistance
right.
back into you.
Right.
Resistance that wasn't there before when you felt that way.
Right.
So you just have to keep working the bugs out of the resistance. You have to say, wait a minute, I was where they are and I discovered this and I discovered this freedom. I discovered this breathing. I discovered this ability to know. I discovered this self-love. I discovered this belief in mm-hmm. self. I discovered how to allow source who knows who I am to flow through me fully. And I want that for each and every one of them. I want everybody to feel invincible. I want everybody to be happy. I want everybody to feel love. I want the world to know what I know. Oh, wait, they don't know. They're not smart enough. They live there. They won't get it. They have that religion. Oh, that religion. No chance they'll ever listen to me. Even though the basis of that religion was exactly this, you see.
Yeah.
Somewhere back there, they all knew this, you
yeah.
see.
Yeah.
So what happens? People all over the planet are doing some version of what we are talking about here. Where you
yeah.
come, your source energy, and you discover a way to let it flow. And then it stops flowing for
yeah.
a minute. So what's the hang-up? I reverted to old, bogus thoughts. I reverted to old, false beliefs. I stopped for a moment remembering what I had to remember before it was there.
Right.
First question, I've got it figured out here. How can I apply it to everything?
So right.
just keep applying it. Just keep applying it and work the bugs out when they turn up. And the way you work the bugs out is appreciate every chance you get if it goes easy. And if appreciation doesn't come easy, don't push it. Because you're just making more resistance when you try to appreciate when it doesn't go easy. Go general. Go general. Go back to the basics until you feel it beginning to happen again. And then as you do that enough, you see, every time you get specific, even though you don't make it, the vortex has it. The source within you has it. Every time you go general, you get closer to it. If that's the only thing you ever knew, it would be enough, you see. Enough to live happily ever after and uplift everybody you meet to live happily ever after. That would be enough.
So did that chronic fatigue thing that I'd had for 20 years, I'm trying to find the...
We would use different words. We wouldn't use chronic. Ah,
right.
And you wouldn't use fatigue.
Resistance.
We would use much. That was Jerry. We would find different words. We would say, so when my delight dips a little.
Right.
Maybe too light and fluffy.
Yeah.
So when I really don't feel like it, that's lighter still, but
yeah.
chronic fatigue,
yeah.
are you kidding?
It's a bad habit to say that. Yeah.
Oh, it just locks you
yeah.
right in. It just
yeah.
locks you right in.
Yeah.
It's chronic, which means constant, and it's fatigue,
yeah.
which means not flowing.
I'll never say it again.
That was our humorous point. And if you weren't up for it, we wouldn't have given it to you so strongly.
Oh, I'm totally up for it. And I will go general and find those feelings that I had with the book and just keep expanding. And then I'll know the right time and feeling to start our course.
The right time. You see, the timing of things. Write this down. It's really good. It's the right time now.
Yeah.
It's the right time now.
To teach.
The time is always right.
Yeah.
The question is, what's the level of resistance? Because
right.
timing is only about the diminishment of resistance.
Right.
So when resistance diminishes enough that manifestation can occur, that's what you call timing.
Right. Okay.
So the timing is always right. It's just how long is it going to take me to get rid of the resistance?
Right.
And get rid of the resistance is the wrong word too. To allow the alignment is the right way of saying it. To allow the alignment. There are other ends of the same thing. But
okay, well, I'll just keep saying allow the alignment and I won't say those other words.
Well, we may.
Yeah. Thank you.